Zero's Blade here, bringing you the top 5 things you need to know about Masteries so you can zero in and win more. Coming in at number 5, the first thing you should know about Masteries is what they are. And their League of Legends talent tree system, basically they're what you're going to use to gear your champions toward the specific role, whether you want to be ability power damage, attack damage, you want to be a tank, you want to be support, you want to be focused on a caster support, tank support, jungler, whatever role you want to play, Masteries are what you're going to fine tune to do that. Next up at number 4 is how many mastery pages you can have and why it's relevant. You can have up to 20 mastery pages, which means that there is more than enough to have one for each role, as well as specific differences in that role. What I mean when I say that is that you could have an AP mid that is geared more towards being the defensive, you know, higher magic resists, higher health pool, sustain through the lane. Something like Swain is a good example. A more aggressive page looks something like this one, where you're a little bit more poke-heavy champion, harass, something like Xerath, Lux. Next up at number 3 is the specific mastery points that, where 1 or 2 points can completely change the way you play. Arcane Blade is a good example, where it says basics attacks also deal bonus magic damage equal to 5% of your ability power. On an AP champion, where you're going to be auto-attacking a lot, this can be incredibly relevant and add up to a lot of damage. The first ones that come to mind are somebody like Swain, maybe, Lux. Basically any champion where you're encouraged to auto-attack as much as possible. But if you're playing somebody like Fiddlesticks, you're not really going to be auto-attacking that much, or it won't be as relevant to your kit. So a point like this could be better spent somewhere else, like Sorcery, getting additional cooldown reduction instead of that. Another good example is when you're talking about AD damage champions, especially AD carries, where you're going to build to be able to crit. Frenzy adds up to be an incredible amount of auto-attack damage, gaining 5% attack speed each time you crit. Up to 3 times, that's 15% more attack speed. There's other champions where it's relevant that are designed to crit, like Yasuo is a great example of a champion that is going to crit and could make good use of this talent. One last example here, a tree like this is something similar to what you would use on Ryze. And the reason for that is Ryze scales off his mana pool more than his AP. So you picking up talents like Expanded Mind, where it says increase your maximum mana by 5%, is more effective towards his scaling than trying to pick up the equivalent of ability power. And in doing so, you actually get some fun spell vamp lifesteal, you know, biscuits, all the good stuff. All right, at number 2, guys, the thing I want to tell you is one of the most important things you can know about Masteries, and that is that while bad Masteries can cause you to lose the lane, not be able to trade effectively, etc., good Masteries don't mean that you necessarily are going to win that lane. Just because you have good Masteries, or even better Masteries than your opponent, doesn't mean that you're automatically set up to win that lane. So don't take them for granted, but don't let them go to your head. You've got perfect Masteries on, he doesn't, so you automatically win, because that's not always the case. Champion counterpicks are extremely relevant. Playstyles to the Masteries are extremely relevant. Something I'll cover in a later video is how to tune your Masteries to your specific playstyle. And number 1, guys, is the sites you can use to your advantage to see your Masteries versus other people's Masteries. The first one up I want to show you is LOL Nexus. It is a great tool that allows you to look at both the people's runes and Masteries, as well as their KDAs, their wins, their losses, what division they're in, things like that. This example here, you can see, you can click on me for this game, and it loads up the Mastery page. You can see as I'm playing Trist in this game, the opposing Ezreal, you can go in here, click on his Mastery, see what he's running, and you can see that he is running some cooldown reduction along with the attack speed, generic basic extra health. He's not running any of the AP talents, so his early game isn't that crazy ridiculous Ez poke that some people tend to run. You can click on Gragas, see that he's tank, you know, took his defensive Masteries. relevant here is that Cho went on the damage side and not the tank side, so that's something you can use for this game. You're also able to look at their runes. It's got 11 armor. It's kind of noticeable. 9's kind of average, so you know that he's going to be a little bit tankier than normal. The lifesteal, he's kind of going more the sustain route. I just want to show you this other tool. It's called LOL Wiz. It's an app through Overwolf that appears as an in-game overlay that will also display the masteries and runes for all the champions. This resource, however, will only display the masteries and numbers. You can't click it. You can't get any additional information other than where they've invested their points. But it's still a very useful tool to have. So just keep it in mind. So that'll about do it for today. Thanks for tuning in. And if you found any of this information helpful, be sure to hit that like and subscribe button below.